Om Namah Shivaya children. We are continuing with the chapter Societal Impact. Today's topic is net and communication etiquettes, which in short is also called netiquettes. So netiquettes is basically the etiquette that one must follow while being online or while interacting or communicating online. So let's read. Netiquette is the short form of internet etiquette or communication etiquettes over the internet. Just like an etiquette, a code of polite behavior in society, netiquette is a code of good behavior while being online or while working on the internet. It includes several aspects of the internet such as social media, email, online chat, web forums, website comments, multiplayer gaming and other types of online communication. So wherever we are communicating online, be it social media chats, commenting on someone's post, or nowadays multiplayer games, we many a times indulge with gaming where people from many other countries also participates. So whenever this online communication is there, we have to follow certain etiquettes or netiquettes. So while working online, netiquettes revolve around the general idea of respecting others online. So let's quickly do what are the do's and don'ts in netiquettes. So do's is keep messages and posts brief, not to write long posts because it's very difficult to follow long posts. Reread your post or emails to make sure they say what you intend. Before posting it, reread and then only post. Remember that you leave a digital footprint. Digital footprint means impression or traces. So whatever you are doing digitally or online, it is being followed. So you have to be very careful about what you write. Use discretion. Discretion basically means the power to make decisions by yourself. So while doing anything, you have to be careful about what you are doing on your own. You have to decide. Next is include a subject line in an email. Very important, because once a person is reading an email, first the person reads the subject line. So subject line, like you write subjects in a letter, you should also always include subject line in an email. Protect personal information. Personal information is not to be shared. You have to be protective about it. Obey copyright rules. Copyright is a very serious issue. So while posting anything or sharing anything online, it may be any post, it may be any software, it may be using any videos or audios or any kind of creative things, you have to follow copyright laws. You cannot copy others' things. Stay focused and stick to the topic. Don't beat about the bush. Whenever you are being online, stay always focused and be on the topic that you intended to share. Now come to the don'ts. Post inflammatory offensive comments. Never to post offensive comments. Write in all caps. Very bad habit. You should not write in caps. It is considered as shouting on the net. Writing caps is only, it's nothing but shouting on to bring attention. So all the time you need not bring attention to all the posts. So you should never write in all caps. Next is don't respond to the internet trollers or personal attacks, because personal attacks and trolls is a very common thing. You should not indulge in all those things and don't respond to all those things. Don't post private or embarrassing images or comments. You should be always protective about your privacy. Don't use sarcasm or it might be misinterpreted. Don't violate copyright laws. You should never violate copyright laws. Make sure your work is your own or properly cited. Exclude people or talk behind their backs. Don't exclude people. I think it will be don't include people or talk behind their backs. I think you should never, don't exclude people. That means don't exclude the people from your group and, you know, you indulge in groupism and talk behind their backs. So this is not correct in when you are being online or in a social media. Then don't spam others by sending large number of unsolicited emails. Even messaging, when you are messaging or when you are writing emails, don't go on sending spams, same message again and again. It is like disturbing your reader. So these are the few do's and don'ts that you should follow if you have to behave yourself properly while being online. Or these are the netiquettes to be followed and the do's and don'ts that you should always follow while being online. So the next topic is data protection. That is, while being online, how to protect your data. So data protection addresses the practices, safeguards and binding rules put in place to protect your personal information and ensure that it remains in control while working online. In short, you should be able to decide what information should be shared, who has access to it, very important, what you're sharing and who has access, for how long and for what reason, and whether rights to modify some of this information should be given or not. So what you're sharing, with whom you're sharing, for how long you're sharing, and moreover, the thing that you're sharing can be modified by a person or not. So this entire control should be on the user while being online. Data protection secures sensitive data from databases to big data, cloud, file system and other crucial applications. Whenever you're sharing data in the cloud, that is on internet, or you're saving in the file system, or you're using any kind of applications, you have to be very much protective about the data while sharing. One must ensure that there shouldn't be any kind of unprotected data or data breach, as it can result to serious issues. So what can be serious issues if you are not protective about those data? Physical data loss, your data might get lost. Attack by a virus or worm or any malicious code, your data might be affected by viruses. Targeted by hackers, if you're not careful about your data, it might be targeted by the hackers. They can get your passwords, and it might be very dangerous if you're working online, if you're doing any kind of monetary transactions online. Distributed denial of service attacks. DDoS, if it can be explained in short, it is when multiple systems flood the bandwidth or resources of a targeted system, usually when there is more web servers available. What happens is, in this kind of attack, the result of multiple systems floods the targeted system with traffic. So this is a cyber attack in which there is lots of targeted traffic, because of which the system gets overloaded and it prevents some required requests from being fulfilled. So since there is lots of traffic, the actual request which needs to be fulfilled because of the overloading cannot be fulfilled. So that is distributed denial of service. Next is loss of money. Of course, if you are sharing your passwords and you're doing online transaction, there might be loss of money. Intellectual property right, property at risk. So if you are doing any kind of creative work and you're sharing your information without taking care, then your copyright or intellectual property right might be at risk. So what you need to do in order to prevent the serious issues? So while working online, this is what you should follow. Through data encryption, whenever you are sharing the data, your data, you have to try to encrypt the data, that is code the data, so that everybody or the hacker in the way may not hack your data. So it is generally taken care of the web servers only, or the sites which deals with money transaction, or they only take care of data encryption so that the data are saved. Next is not sharing private information such as passwords, credit card credentials, etc. This is absolutely private and you should not share with others. Not oversharing on social networking sites. Many a times on social networking sites, we overshare our locations, our phone details, our contacts, many other things, which is not to be shared online. We should be sharing things in a very restrictive manner. Next is adopting complete security mechanism for protection against possible threats. So all kind of security mechanisms, like in your side you can load antivirus. You should not go to any sites which can have any kind of virus attacks. You should avoid. Next is avoiding opening phishing emails. There are many fraud emails that often you get about the lotteries, etc. So those kind of emails you should not generally open. There might be any kind of virus attacks or fraudulent mails you might get, and you might fall into trap. So you need not open or reply to the such kind of emails. Being careful about using Wi-Fi connections. Wi-Fi connection is an open connection. Many a times in order to use the free Wi-Fi connections, we often access those Wi-Fi connections. So since it's open, your data might be at risk. The last one, being alert to impersonators. Impersonating means trying to be someone else. There are many such kind of things that happens on internet. The people impersonate many companies which impersonate the other company, and they try to fraud you. You are thinking that it's an authorized company and you are doing any kind of transactions, but you get to know that it is only simply impersonating and it is not the normal person. So this kind of issues might happen being online. So these are the things that you should take care of when you are online. So today you have learned two topics. The first one is netiquettes, or the etiquette that one should follow when being online, and a very important topic, data protection. That is how you should protect your data when you are sharing your data online. So go through the topic, go through my video lecture, make notes according to where I have underlined the things, and we will proceed with the chapter in the next video. Namaste, children.